Hi everyone, my name is Leah Kopke and I'm a 3D motion design freelancer. In each one of these episodes, we go over another 3D modeling tool. In today's episode, we're going over the guide tool and how it works. You can use it to create other guide objects, like a guideline object or a guide plane object. And we'll go through the differences between those. So what's different about this and the guides that we've gone over in the past is that these guides are permanent. And the guides that we were creating in the past with the perpendicular guide or the dynamic guide, those were temporary guides, but these guides aren't temporary and you can use them as a reference as you 3D model. So if you take measurements of objects that you'd like to 3D model in real life, with a trusty tape measure, or you could use your very helpful calipers depending on how big of an object you're actually modeling. You can take measurements and use these guides in order to help you 3D model them to fit those measurements. So once we go through this, I think we can really start getting into 3D modeling objects in future tutorials a little bit more, because you'll know a pretty good number of tools by this point if you've been following along in this podcast. So let's jump into Cinema 4D and show how the guide tool works. So here we are inside of Cinema 4D. I've actually turned on the snap tool and I've turned on quantize. And the reason why I've done that is because we can use quantize and snap settings in order to snap our guide while we're building them with our guide tool. So you'll notice that we've actually covered the snap settings and the quantize settings in past lessons. So if you're interested in checking those out, you can see them. They're just earlier in this podcast. And these are really helpful because we can also use them to draw guides. And I'll turn on grid/work plane so that we can snap to our grid points and we can snap to our grid lines. Right now we are in perspective view. I find it easier to create guides in either the right view, front view, or top view. These are also called orthographic views. So one of these orthographic views I find most useful to create guides in rather than perspective view. And I can click on the middle mouse button to see these four views, and then I can click on the middle mouse button again in one of these views in order to make that view a little bit bigger. So I'll do that in the right view. Over here, you'll see we have our guide tool, and it says that it draws and edits guides. So it's really nice that when you hover over these, they give you a pretty simple description of what the tool does. But we're definitely going to dive into this a whole lot more. When you click on it, it turns purple and we have our snaps on, so I can snap to this grid point and start drawing a guide with our guide tool activated. So when I've made 2 points, you'll see that now we have a guide object in our object manager. You can see that since we've only made 2 points, it's showing this icon that looks like a line. And it says the type is a line. And I can just hit the escape button now and we'll just have a line guide. But you'll see that as I move this around, it's giving me the option to make a third point. And if I decide that I want to make a third point and I click my mouse again here, now the icon has changed and we've made a plane. And you can see that it's also updated the icon in the object manager. So you can create planes as well as lines as construction references for your 3D modeling. Here you can see the type. And we can actually change this back to being a line if we'd like to. And let's explore the settings for a line guide initially. If I hit the middle mouse button again, you can see where our guide is in space in the other views. Just as a reference, I'll go back into this one. So right now we have our line mode set to infinite. And just like how the name sounds, it creates a line that's infinite in both directions. So it goes on forever. If you change this to half line, it'll go on forever, but only in one direction and not in both. If you change this to segment, it will be a segment. It will not go on infinitely in either direction. If you turn on spatial mode, I'll actually show this in perspective view because it will be a little bit easier for you to see this. If I click spatial mode, it will make additional guides for us to see where our guide is in space. So it just creates some extra visual guides for us. If I click this off, those guides go away. Here you can adjust how many units you would like this guide to be. Right now it's 600, we could make it 200. You can adjust the dimensions there. You can also go ahead and pull on different parts of the guides in order to move it. I'm going to hit undo. Those two red dots are, or orange dots, they actually look more orange, but those two orange dots allow you to adjust your guides. And there's orange dots also on the plane guide, which you'll see in a moment. I'm going to make the 600 again. So that gives you the idea of how this works, and you can use these as a 3D modeling reference for measurements. And you can snap to them as well if you'd like to. So let's say we decide to make this a plane instead. I'm going to click right here and you'll see we still have these orange dots that we can move around and we can adjust. We're still snapping to our grid because we have that on. And down here you'll see that we still have spatial mode as an option. So I'll show that again in perspective view because it's easier to see. This is what the plane looks like with spatial mode off. If we turn it on, we can see some more guides as references for our plane. And you might find that helpful for 3D modeling if you want to keep something within a certain bounding box. Like let's say you're 3D modeling a chair and you know that the chair needs to fit within certain dimensional constraints, you can do that and use this as a reference for making sure that your 3D model chair fits within those constraints. I'm going to turn off spatial mode again, and we'll look at this again in the right view. You'll see we can adjust this in the X and Z directions. You can type in dimensions again here. And if you want to be in different units, you can go under Edit Preferences and click on Units. And in here, you can choose from this drop-down menu what units you would like to work within. Axis Centered is the last option for the plane object. And right now you'll see, since we have that off, there's an orange dot at the ends of this plane. And these are our controls. If you want to use controls that are centered on the plane, you can select this box, and now you'll see that our controls have moved to the center of the plane. So it's just another way to adjust your plane. And you can see we can still move it and adjust it based on these. So I hope you found this tutorial helpful, and I look forward to seeing you in future tutorials, and we'll definitely get into 3D modeling actual objects a little bit more in the future, because I feel like we've covered a good number of tools at this point, which is really exciting. And if you'd like to learn more 3D modeling tools inside of Cinema 4D, please hit like and subscribe so that you're notified when the next tutorial comes out. And I'll see you next time on Ambient 3D Animations. Thank you so much for watching.